Let's kill two birds with one stone, shall we? Sheryl Plouffe here, video strategist. I help entrepreneurs increase their authority and income with video. And in this tutorial, I'm gonna show you how to leverage your Zoom meetings that you're already having and share that to your Facebook audience simultaneously through Facebook Live. Be sure to like this video, hit the bell for notifications, and subscribe to the channel. I'm gonna show you how it's done by heading over to my computer. So let's go there now. Now, I will say this, the screen captures on this help article are from the classic Facebook view, whereas now Facebook has released the new Facebook layout and design, which I have activated on my page, and so it does look a little bit different. So this will be helpful for you to see what it looks like in the new Facebook view. So let's go through this, and what we're looking to do is to find out, am I an administrator or at least an editor of my own Facebook page? Now, I happen to know that I am, but I will show you the steps to follow in this case. So what we're really trying to do is we're trying to find the page roles feature on our page. I'm gonna go over to Facebook and I'm just gonna start from the beginning here. So we're just at Facebook, and what I'll do is I'll click on pages, identify my page. I'm gonna scroll down to page settings. From page settings, I'm scrolling down a little further to find page roles. And once I click on page roles, I can see here that I am indeed an administrator of my page. So now to figure out if we are indeed an administrator of a group, we can click on the article here. It'll tell you, you know, how to check that. And how it looks on the new Facebook layout is this. Go over to Facebook, I'm starting from the beginning again, and this time I will click on groups. When I click on groups, it's divided into groups I manage and groups that I am a part of. If you want to live stream your Zoom to a group and you do not see it under groups you manage, then that means you are not managing that group and therefore cannot live stream to it. You cannot stream to a group that you are only a member of. You can only stream to a group that you manage. And this is how you would find that in the new Facebook layout. Now let's jump back up over here to enabling Facebook live streaming for meetings. And I am going to focus on meetings in this particular video, but you can clearly see that there are some instructions here for webinars as well. But we're going to talk about meetings here because meetings is typically what most of you probably have. It is an extra fee to enable webinars on Zoom. So let's do it from the perspective of meetings. So we're going to go over to our account settings. So let's go over to Zoom, and I'm right over here. And you can actually see that the article also can pop up here on the help widget on the left, on the right-hand side. And so what we're doing is we're going to go down, to the section. It's a little bit further down. It's quite a ways down here. You can see all of the different features that you can enable on Zoom, but here it is right here. So it's pretty much 3/4 of the way down on this page, and it says allow live streaming meetings. So you'll want to have that toggled on, and you'll want to have, in this case, Facebook check marked as yes, I want to live stream my meeting to Facebook. So let's go back to the top of the article. So we've done our enabling. We have done our permissions. We're going to skip over webinars for the purpose of this video. And we are going to just briefly mention here that the tips for live streaming on Facebook, there is a 20-second processing time. So once you are sharing your Zoom meeting on Facebook Live, the people who watch your Facebook Live are going to see it about 20 seconds later than the people who watch it on Zoom, because remember that there's a bit of a lag and they're watching it at the same time with the exception of that 20-second delay. And there's also an audio echo that could be a problem for some of you, and it talks here about how this happens when you have a Facebook window open on your computer and you're hearing your audio playing back. So one way to do that is to on the bottom right hand side would be to check mark the audio to mute the video in that case. And so it would really help you with the audio part portion of this and to avoid that awful echo that could happen. So as we continue to do our steps here, and we've talked about these parts here, let's get into the meat and potatoes of it, which is actually how do we live stream on Facebook. So I'm starting any meeting and we see the Zoom, application box prompt come up. And so I'm going to say yes. I'm going to say join this chat, join this with computer audio. And I will now open up and turn on the light so you can actually see me turning on the video. So there I am. Okay. So this is, again, your typical Zoom meeting that we are about to start. And in fact, the meeting has already begun. I see myself on the screen. But what I'll do now is I'll click on the More button at the bottom right-hand side, click on the three dots, and you'll see a pop-up box that asks you whether you would like to go live on a custom live streaming service, on YouTube, or on Facebook. So in this case, we'll click on Live on Facebook. So now a box pops up that asks me where I want to go, and I'm going to say I want to share this Zoom meeting on a group or in a group. I'm going to choose Cash in on camera, next. So what this is doing is making the connection between Zoom and my Facebook Live on my group that I've chosen to go and share this meeting with. I'm just going to dismiss the live producer for the time being. It's fetching the video stream. This can take a few seconds. I could also over here post something like test, or whatever it is I'm writing in here. I write something. And I could also put a title in here. So, sharing Zoom meeting with your audience, let's just say. Okay. And I can see that I'm getting a green light here. So the stream is looking like it's good. Fetching video stream. Okay, great. And now I can go live. Check that your stream is connected and all required information is provided before going live. So I do have my title. I've posted something here. I could also add a poll question. I haven't used this function very much, but there is a functionality there for some interactivity, which is great. I could also put some, just like a typical Facebook post, you could add, your city if I wanted to do that, or, how I'm feeling and tag people in the post. But for the purpose of this demonstration, I'll keep it simple. So then you would just click go live. And now we are live on Facebook as well. So the meeting is in progress on Zoom, but I am also now, as you can see on the top left-hand side, I am streaming this also to Facebook. But keep in mind, there is a 20-second delay. So for those of you watching on Facebook, you're seeing what I'm saying 20 seconds in the future from when it actually is happening. So there is that to consider, but it's a really great way to be able to, again, communicate your meeting, share your meeting onto a Facebook Live broadcast. So for those of you who are watching on the group right now and are confused, I'm creating my video for tomorrow about how to use Zoom, since it's such a relevant topic right now and so many people are using Zoom. How do we actually do that in real time to share that out to your Facebook Live? So that's how you do it. At this point, what I could do is just end the meeting. Right? So I'm ending the meeting for all, and that will effectively cut off the feed, the meeting to Facebook Live and stop the Facebook Live broadcast. So that's how it goes. There you can see. So there's a 20-second delay. I should see this feed stick on my group for probably another, 5 or so seconds in the time that I hit end. So we can even watch this happen in real time. You can see on the bottom right-hand side where it says Zoom, that was where the feed really originated from in a meeting format. And now that's actually going to come to an end, probably any second now, as 20 seconds have expired between the time that I hit end and when it's actually going to end on my group. I think there we go. So it ended. And that's how it would look on your Facebook group, since that's where we decided to share that Zoom meeting.
And that's it. That's how you can share your Zoom meeting with your Facebook Live audience and really exponentially reach more people. So be sure to watch these other Facebook Live and Zoom related videos on my channel. Please subscribe, hit the notification bell. New videos come out every Thursday. Thanks so much for watching.